In this video, I wanted to show you how I used a couple of Google Sheet functions to make it easier to grade student progress in Quizlet. Check out the post on my site about why I love using Quizlet in my class. As you can see here, I have two different Google Sheets open. The one on my left is my Quizlet calculator, and the one on my right is my gradebook. First, let's look at calculating a grade. In my class, all the grades are an order of magnitude higher than most classes, so a student can earn 50 points for each of the 7 different activities for a total of 350 points per set of vocabulary. When I'm putting grades in, it's faster if I don't have to type 2-digit numbers, so I use the equals ifs function of Google Sheets to translate a 2 into a full credit grade of 50 points and a 1 to equal a half credit grade of 25 points. So grading looks like this. I pull up the class progress of my Quizlet, and I'm going to use the first 5 students here in my actual class to show you how I would grade these students. So I'm going to come over here to Amy Pond, who will be the first student on the list, and I'm going to click into the Learn activity, and I'm just going to be looking at the class progress on Quizlet and typing in a 2 for every green check and a 1 for every dark gray icon, and I'm not going to type anything in for a light gray icon. And I'm going to go down each of the columns. So by going through that list and typing in the 2s and the 1s and skipping anyone who hasn't done that activity, I have graded all of the students, and I have a total for each of them in the totals column that is at the scale my gradebook is. So if you look in this cell in the totals column, you can see that the formula is long and it might look intimidating, but it's pretty straightforward. All of it says is that sheets should translate a 2 into a 50 or a 1 into a 25 or use a blank as a 0 and then translate that in each cell, so B2, C2, all the way down the line, and it's gonna add up all those translations. So it's not gonna translate it in the actual cell, but in its head as it does the math over here. It's gonna give you the total sum. So that's great because it's translating that into the scale that my gradebook needs. And that's really helpful, but getting it from here into my gradebook can be a little bit of an issue because Quizlet organizes students by username. So that's how I have my Quizlet calculator set up. However, my gradebook uses their actual names, and those might not be the same. So I wanted to look into how Google Sheets could fix this for me, and I found 2 more functions to introduce you to. The first new function to show you is called import range, and you want to navigate to the spreadsheet that you want to receive the data. So I'm going to come over here to my gradebook, and it doesn't matter where, because the first thing we need to do is authorize a connection. So I'm going to use any cell, picked a random one down here, and I'm going to hit equals and start typing the word import range. You can see that there's a couple different options, and I'm going to use the range function. So I'm going to scroll down to import range, and I'm going to hit enter. And then it gives me this helpful tutorial to basically fill in the blanks down here to make sure that I'm doing it right. I'm going to move up here to the functions bar so that it's easier to see everything and I'm not all cramped. You notice that I need a URL, and this URL is from the spreadsheet that I want to connect to. It's important to notice that there are quotation marks around this. So I'm going to start by opening a quotation mark, and I'm going to come over to my Quizlet calculator. I'm going to copy this URL. I'm going to paste it into the function, and I'm going to close this part of the import range function with a quotation mark. And then I still need to add a comma to separate this. As you can see down here, I'm missing that comma, which is why this is still highlighted. As soon as I type this comma, boom, it moves on to the other fill in the blank, and it shows me what I need. And this is the name of the sheet that I'm going to be using, followed by an exclamation point, and then the cells that I want to import. And right now it doesn't matter because we're just trying to open up this portal, but it does need to be a valid place. I'm going to do another quotation mark, and I'm going to type set B. I'm going to make sure it matches the name that I have down here for this tab. You can see down here where my mouse is. It's going to be the same thing, followed by an exclamation point. And then I'm just going to import this single cell up here. So if I do this correctly, where it says username over here right above Amy Pond will end up going down into this cell that we see here. In order to make that work, I need to type A1 colon A1 close quotation and then close the parentheses, and then that little help box went away. It's because I've completed the function. So I'm going to hit enter, and then what you'll see is that I was not successful, and I wasn't successful because I need to allow access. This you need to do one time in order to connect this spreadsheet, the whole file and all of its different tabs. You need to give permission for these two things to talk to each other, which is why I like having one Quizlet calculator with multiple tabs for all the different Quizlet sets that I need, so I don't have to do this part again. But I'm going to click into here and set allow access. I'm going to click away, and you can see it already brought in that function over here for username. And just to show you that I'm not copying and pasting, I'm going to come over here and I'm going to take off the E, and you'll see that relatively quickly this spreadsheet updates as well. Now that I've opened that connection, I'm going to delete this because I don't need it anymore, but we are going to use the import range function as part of this next thing that I'm going to show you. And the next tool is called a VLOOKUP. But before we use the VLOOKUP function, we are going to give Google Sheets the translation guide. We've given it access, but we still need to give it some logical connection. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to say insert one to the left, and I'm going to make a username column over here in the gradebook. And I'm going to take these usernames from Quizlet and I'm going to basically assign them to a person. And I'm going to make sure that these are all different just so you can see that it's working. And so the function we're going to use is called VLOOKUP. So up here, I'm going to pick where I want this function to work. And so since we're going to be using the Quizlet grade from set B, I'm going to put it over here in the set B column. And I'm going to work up here in the function bar again. I'm going to hit equals VLOOKUP. We have this helpful box, which is going to make things easier for us. And so this is the last step in connecting these two spreadsheets. And this is really where, for me, it really became a eye-opening experience about what you can do with spreadsheets. So I'm going to hide this or minimize this so we have some access down here. And I'm going to say Drax the Destroyer's Captain Harkness. And so I want to know, in Drax the Destroyer's grade, I want to know how Captain Jack Harkness did. So I'm going to pick A2. I'm just going to select it. And it's, you see it comes up here with A2, and this gets highlighted. So now I'm going to hit a comma, and we need to import the range. And so this is where we're telling it to look. This is where we're going to use that import range function again. So this is just going to be the same thing we did before. And we're going to put some quotation marks around this, and then we're going to put a comma. So after we've told it to look at this spreadsheet, we need to tell it to look at this tab. So we're going to put our quotation mark and then set B, exclamation point, and then a money sign, the letter A, colon, money sign, the letter I, and we're going to close the quotation mark. And then we're going to close the parentheses, and that takes care of the import range function. And now we need to address the index. So index is which cell I want it to bring over. So that's going to be the 9th cell. If you use the same Quizlet data calculator that I use, then it'll be the 9th cell. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's the totals column. So I'm going to use the number 9, and then I'm going to put another comma and then type false. That's just has to do with sorting. Almost always, if you're using this function, you want it to say false. And then I'm going to close the parentheses and hit enter. And there it is. Drax the Destroyer is getting the grade that Captain Jack Harkness got for his Quizlet progress. If you have this set up correctly, I can click on this little box in the bottom right-hand corner. I'm going to drag it down, and the formula updates and says, look in A3. So look for Rory Williams and do everything else the same and give Gamora what Rory Williams got. And it does that for everybody. Now let's save time again, because if you're gonna be using Quizlet in your class a lot, then you probably are gonna have multiple vocab sets in your spreadsheet. So copy and paste. And what you'll notice is you're gonna get the same grade. All you have to do is over here for the tab, change this to the vocab set you want. So I change this to set A. If we come over here to set A, no matter how I sort this, you can see Captain Jack Harkness has no grade. But as I give him his grade updates over here. So now he has 350 points. And no matter how I sort this list or how I sort this sheet, that grade stays connected because the words Captain Jack Harkness are really what's being used here. So wherever that word shows up. So it's important for your Quizlet usernames to be unique. And because it's Quizlet usernames, they have to be unique. No two people can have the same Quizlet username on all of Quizlet. So this is a nice unique identifier that you can use in your gradebook. And I can hide this column and just have the student name and still have all of this work and live update, even though it's hidden. So for the purpose of creating a Quizlet grade calculator, you certainly have to use Quizlet a lot in order for this to save you time. I do use it a lot, so I find it to be a very useful thing for me to set up. But what you can see here, hopefully, is some potential for you to use the VLOOKUP and import range function to have different workspaces for the things that you are working on, so different spreadsheets for different projects, and then be able to report that information from one spreadsheet to another spreadsheet and keep those two spreadsheets kind of live updated and in sync. So hopefully this saves you some time and gives you some food for thought when it comes to setting up some projects and keeping some data synced.